based on that time, which of the years, how much damage you've done to the bike. And if it's like, oh, it's just a wheel well, it takes like a month to really get into the pain or the part that it's just a wheel well. If it's a wheel well fall, I'll ride it, so you guys give it a part thing, but
I'm going to go.
that guard up and then level change, right? So anytime somebody rushes in, right, stick that shoulder in their chest, right? Instead of getting caught in skates, right? So walk in, right? Get that guard up. Yep. So what I, again, the shoulder bump, what I don't, and me, I got the short arm, so I bike inside, especially big guys like you. But what I don't want to do is I don't want to reach. Right? I don't want to. This is okay once in a while. Like, say I'm just trying to create space if things are flowing. But what I don't want to do is lean in when I'm trying to shoulder bump. Because now there's all this space here, and I'm reaching, right? What I'm doing is I'm using your momentum. So as you walk in, like, go ahead, walk in. I'm level changing as a slip, and I'm putting that shoulder right in their chest.
That's cool.
Right? Tuck the chin up in there. So, again, don't do this, right? Chin is tucked. Boom. You're just using their momentum. Work. So, you're using your jab a lot, which is good, right? But he's countering off of it, right? So, use feints, right? Feint the jab until it crosses. So, straight punch, right? But don't get so repetitive with your punches, right? You can start up the pattern, but then that's where a good feint comes in. Straight right and left. Yeah. So say you're reading. keep your guard tight, and it's a reading thing, right? So what he, assuming read on cue, was just pawing with the jab, right? And he was able to push it up.
Yeah, I was trying to do it.
Yeah, I saw it a couple times.
Yeah.
So that's one movement. So say you see this, right? You're literally just going to take your jab underneath mine and change levels and go to the body. Just be, again, remember you guys are training partners. Be careful where you're hitting. Right, that floating rib is real easy to break and it's real hard to heal.
Yeah, right.
So, solar plex would be a better place. It still hurts, but you're not going to break your solar plex. You're going to get the air knocked out of you for it seems like a day. But again, that floating rib, that's be careful. Right? So when you are going, just be mindful of each other, right? So anytime I do that, like a body shot there, I try to hold a little bit or just cut it.
You're doing that.
What's that?
You have to just a ton of
yeah. Remember, because your ribs, right, they're intact, so that floating, it's got nothing underneath. A lot easier to break. Just be careful if you go there. All right.
So you're pushing with your left hand out or your right hand?
Keep going.
Thank you. because I'm not.
I'm trying to do it, but it's.
But I do it because I'm afraid I'm not getting too close, you know?
But you're kind of open, let me do it.
Yeah, but the
difference is his chin's also tucked and his back foot's not coming off the ground as much.
Yeah.
Right. He's sitting more. Right. I can still step in with it. As long as that chin's tucked, if it's a straight punch, you're good. But what's happening with you is you kind of get caught out here. Right? And so in this case, I'm gonna roll right away.
Yeah, and still with kickboxing I'm not used to like going down and exposing. But that helps so much in boxing.
Yeah.
Okay. You gotta work on that.
Yeah, that's good. Back in the day, I was gonna marry her, but then I found out she likes women, and well, I didn't stand a chance.
I was gonna marry her too.
You still might be able to. I'm out. You excluded me.
So, Justin, during a fight, like right now, like starting to tense up.
Yep.
What can I do to my body?
If you're tensing up, so breathing exercises, right? It's the same thing with giving a speech, right? There's times, even with me, it's like, especially, you know, ring rust and not being in here, starting to get cracked. The tighter you are, right, the less reactive you're going to be. So, what I do is I'll literally just step back. Breathe. And I force myself into relaxation. Even if you're dropping your hands for a second, shaking the blood, nice and relaxed. What I try to do is get instead of tensing up, I'll force myself just to be loose and move a little bit. Breathe. Not shallow breaths, not one long, big, deep breath, but just a medium. High school, minus the backyard, I
defense, man.
We're
getting perfect.
Yeah, that last little bit, good roll under, right?
Yeah.
You like kind of got stuck?
Did it look like it?
Yeah, and you rolled under good, but then you kind of froze up.
Okay. As far as
it, just move it. Just remember, whenever I move, whether it's a slip, rolling, I'm always going to come back my good base.
You know what feels like it, kind of don't.
Just keep your eyes on your opponent, right? I think what happened is kind of got here and lost him, right? Do your best, right? Make a miss and just make sure you see him. You can see a punch coming from right here.
I also noticed that when I go down, it's very extra work to keep my hands up. It's much easier to do this
without the weight
here.
Yep. So when I slip, and it's because I'm comfortable doing it, I'll throw one arm and one angle. It helps the movement. Right? You just gotta be aware of what side you're going to, right? If I'm gonna slip to the right, what I'm not gonna do is this, right? Now it's frozen movement. But I do this when it helps, right? It's literally just getting your comfortable and I can defend here. Right? So right, just make sure you bring them back. It's okay to move and again, like say I roll, right? I'll come under. For that split second, you can drop them. Just make sure as you come up, you see what's coming, and back up. So you don't have to stay here the whole time, right? It's better to be technical, but just make sure as you come out of the movement, be aware of where you're at.
I was also trying to do the shift that we did last time.
Yeah.
Can't do it. Like, I feel like I'm losing. Like, if I either do a cross or a right hook, and then I try to go that direction, it in between is too slow, and it gets me every time.
So, and again, the more relaxed where you can be, you got to be close, right? This is an inside drill, but you just touch, right? Touch.
No, I see. So that's close. That's why, because I'm still, it happens with Justin and him, I'm very hesitant.
Yeah, and rightfully so. I mean, like I said, if with this, especially this movement, if I don't do it correctly, right, it could be that the other end of it is getting punched. But like I said, I don't do this way out here. I'm not going to do this because it's still over there. Now, not only am I can't throw that uppercut when I'm trying to set up, but they're out of range too, and it's just easy. So that's more inside, right? And that stalemate of trying to dig, go to the body, find something, and open it up. That's more of an inside drill. How you guys feeling?
Good. One more,
then I'm going to have you guys do some technique drills together.
Thank you. going.
Thank you.
shot.
Yeah.
Right? And so again, say he touches, right? Touching right back, trying to run and go into the head. But a lot of times, especially in exchanges and movements, there might be a small window where I don't have time to load it up. Just a quick turnover. Touch. Touching score points. You know, nice same thing with boxing. Or any competition, I think kickboxing or boxing. Yeah. More clean shots and touches, right?
At some point, it changed stance.
If you're not
that's it.
At some point, it changed stance because this calf was coming out.
Yeah.
Does that mean that it's too much faster?
Your lead calf? No, it's just you're springing off of it. It's not conditioned for it, right? Jump roping, that's the reason why we jump rope. I know certain, like the knees and everything else, sometimes we stop, but for whatever reason, jump roping is what's going to build up that calf strength. Or literally just drilling this, right? I noticed just, like, I don't have shin splints per se, but there is muscle on the shin too. Yeah. And I think from just teaching in class, constantly doing this, I wake up today and my shin's sore, right? So it's just, there's muscles there that we don't activate a lot, especially if we're just standing still and moving here. I almost think sometimes, not by some great difference, but I think my back half is bigger than that lead because I'm always, most of the time, I'm pushing off that back leg. That back heel stays off the ground more than that lead leg.
Yeah, mine is way smaller, yeah. And that's the one that gives up.
So, again, just thinking, building up the calf, right, if jump roping is too much high impact on the knees, or the shins, calf raises, mm-hmm. step-ups, squatting, anything we do with the leg, it pulls, like, the calves are working, but raising up, right, and I always like to go back, or use a step, because I can drop down then and stretch the calf further. Let's say I'm doing my calf raises on purpose, you pull back, just kind of stretch out the calf in the opposite direction, right, dorsiflexion, plantar flex, so yeah, you gotta build up your calf.
I'm trying to stand more when I work.
Got a standing desk.
I always talk about the shower and how I would work head movement in the shower based off the knowledge of the brick. Yeah. Oh yeah. When I first started taking boxing seriously, and I was just way better moving my head, right? Sometimes I come to the gym and I either wouldn't feel comfortable stringing up a rope in front of people and embarrass myself, right? So I would literally just sit there in front of the shower, right? I'd slip the surface, but just like a punch, right? Coming off that angle, right? So I'm just getting used to moving the hips that way. I would do calf raises in the shower, just right? Be careful, right? Slip up your hips. Yeah, you just gotta build up your calf strength. Jump roping is one way, calf raises.
Well, I'm gonna play soccer.
One thing we used to do when I was kickboxing too is this one. I remember practicing an hour and a half. We were literally just building up the leg strength, coming out of that lunge, and then pushing up on the lead toe, right? The elevated kick, and you got to push on that toe. So, one of those.